my book Fairyland, which I published in 2013 in the United States and in 2015 in France, is a book I've been considering writing for a lot of my life. The book begins and ends with the death of my father. It's no surprise that he dies. But after he died, I found his personal journals. And even before he died, I knew I wanted to tell our story in some way. He raised me alone as a gay father after the death of my mother, and he did so at a time in the 1970s and 80s when to be a single gay father was pretty rare. And so I sort of recognized in him that he was a pioneer of sorts. And I had always wanted to write this book, but it took me a long time to find the right point of view, as is often the case for writers. And part of that was that I needed distance on the story to see myself as a character and to see, you know, what the story had to contribute. And over time, between when my father died in 1992 and I started thinking about the writing, and then when I sold the book in 2010, the American culture had gone through many vast changes, with especially regards to gay rights. And I was feeling at that point that we were talking so much about gay marriage and gay rights, but with very little understanding of gay history and the pioneers of people, of families that were headed by gay mothers or fathers. And so, in addition to feeling that this was a story that was important for me to tell, I felt that the story could be important for the culture to hear in a way, that it was a story that had not yet been told. And in doing so, I was able to enlarge my point of view and see not just that this was a story about me, but that it was a story that was representative of a part of the American experience that was underrepresented. And so I was able to plunge myself into the history, which at times, even though it was a history, it was very familiar to me because it was my personal history, it was a history that details of which I had never really studied. And so I came upon difficult and surprising facts. I've been very happy with the reception of the book in France, especially because a part of the book takes place in France. I lived in France when my father was sick, and in fact, I scattered his ashes in the Seine. And so when I come back to Paris, I go visit the Île Saint-Louis and know that he is there. And so a lot of the success the book has had here, I feel like I'm sharing with him. I think that through literature, writers and readers are able to be transported into other lives and into other times. And so, you know, for me, the great pleasure of writing my book was in getting an empathy for another generation and another era. And through my research and writing, to make that world come alive was to help me make sense of what's going on now. I think that a lot of American literature, maybe the inspiration is sort of a desire to understand ourselves, you know, to do research and to try to find ourselves through the writing, because, you know, we're such an evolving country, and you know, sometimes we don't stop to think about how do we get here, where are we going, and I think the writing helps us do that.